In the next couple of videos, we will look at other constraint based approaches, which are sort of based on flux balance analysis, but they have different kinds of objective functions. So they use the same mass balance constraints and so on, but instead have a different objective function that is more useful in appropriate scenarios. So the first of them is what is known as minimization of metabolic adjustment. So Segre and co-workers basically came up with another strategy which said it may not be valid, as I had on my previous slide. This may not be valid in all situations. Just keep saying maximize growth rate, when you are essentially harassing a cell by knocking out a couple of genes, you do not expect the cell to maximize its growth rate. It might only be trying to survive, right. So the hypothesis here is that the cell survives by minimizing its metabolic adjustment, right. So to speak, it is at a particular metabolic state, it moves to the nearest metabolic state that is compliant with your new constraints. So which brings us to the first question. How do you delete a gene? How do you delete a gene from a metabolic model? From a model? What metabolite? I am saying you remove a, I am asking you about removing a gene.
You remove its product from the model
gene. No, right. So the gene is basically some, an enzyme which catalyzes a reaction. So you need to remove the a particular reaction from the model. So how do you remove a reaction from a model? So you can basically remove the entire column from the stoichiometric matrix. That would be the naive way. The easier way is to basically add an additional constraint saying V5 equals 0. You want to remove reaction 5, you say V5 equals 0. Once you do that, you have a new optimization to solve, right. S3 equals 0 is always, right. So let us not even worry about it. So now let us say you did maximize C transpose V such that SV equal to 0 and you came up with some V wild type. Now I say go and delete reaction 5. So I say V5 equals 0 in addition to SV equals 0 and I again maximize C transpose V to find some other V dash which is V deleted. Some other V which is V deleted. But it may not be fair to ask the cell to maximize its growth. It is under some stress. So what Segre and co-workers suggested was, why not we minimize the distance between VW and VD. Mathematically, what would this be? Right. So minimize such that SVD equals 0. Of course, you know V5 equals 0 as well. Whatever deletion you inflicted on the organism. So this becomes a quadratic programming problem. Because you see the square. So we'll follow this up in the next class. Let's look at some other constraint based approaches. FBA is the vanilla basic constraint based approaches. There are many constraint based approaches that have been built more or less related to FBA, but they use different ideas for objective function, different optimization formulations and so on. So the first, what is the major, in some sense, a weakness of FBA? It necessitates this objective function no matter what. So yesterday we were looking at how do we optimize in terms whenever there is a gene deletion, right. So we said we'll stick to the same So I said we will stick to the same formulation, right? So which basically looks like maximize C transpose V such that SV equals 0, but additionally some VK equals 0. This means this reaction is additionally pinned to 0. You can even pin it to some value, right? So in, for example, if you wanted to find out what is the max, we were talking about this yesterday, right? V of lycopene, you may say that V bio equals V bio star and now maximize V lycopene, right? So this is basically another constraint wherein we are pinning fluxes. So note this idea of pinning fluxes. So you pin a flux to a particular value or pin a flux to a zero value and so on, right? But the issue comes is comes when you say you want to maximize growth again. Let us say you are saying V5 equal to 0, V6 equal to 0, V7 equal to 0. You have knocked out 3 reactions. Would the organism still be trying to maximize its growth? See, what is your FB objective function? You are literally trying to second guess what the organism is doing. The organism under abundant nutrient conditions, the organism is trying to maximize its growth probably. So when you assume that, you get a nice fit to the experimental predictions and so on. But what happens when you are deleting too many genes and so on? The organism may not be able to grow as freely as before. So maybe one hypothesis that people came up with was under some conditions, the organism finds a new distribution that is minimally different from the wild type distribution. Mathematically, how would we put this? And you can square it as well. What does this translate into? Let us look. So this is VD transpose. VD transpose VD plus VW transpose VW minus 2 VD transpose VW. You can leave this out. It is a constant. Right? VW is, what is VW? The initial flux distribution which you might have experimentally measured or obtained via FBA again. Both are possibilities. You obtained it through some other means, right? You have an initial, you know what was the initial state of the cell. So if you want to look at it pictorially, of course we can look at only two dimensions. So pictorially, let us say this was the initial optimum and now you have an additional constraint which might be making one of these 0, but let us say the constraint changes like this, or that is too close. Let us look at something like this. You have to find the new optimum. If you were to use FBA, you might say this is the new optimum, but now you might find what is closest to the original point in terms of this. And what does this translate to? I will just write it a little differently. Let us just divide by 2 and this will give us half VD transpose I VD. I am just putting the identity matrix in between, minus plus minus VW transpose into VD. You could have written this anyway, right? This is the same as writing. So why am I writing it in this form? I am trying to bring it to the canonical QP form, quadratic formulation, quadratic programming formulation, right? So what is your LP to remind you is F transpose X such that AX equals B. You can also have AX greater than or equal to B, whatever. The QP formulation is similar. It is half X transpose AX plus B transpose X, or
more correct terminology would be half exponent of qx plus your good old c transpose x. Why is this form important? Because that's what every solver will use, right? So every solver will expect arguments in this form. So let's go back to matrix, no? Right, it's just identity matrix.
Okay.
So which is same as Q.
Okay.
So you'll need to give an identity matrix to MATLAB or whatever quadratic programming solver you're using. So you have a.
So instead of Q, we will give an identity.
You give an identity matrix. And here you will give the negated version of the wild type flux.
Wait, why is
wild
VW transpose VW 0?
It's not 0. I'm just ignoring it. It's just a large positive quantity. I don't have to worry about optimizing it. If I am going to optimize x square plus 4, I might as well just optimize x square. It is going to be giving me the same result. Yeah, this is not 0, this is neglected. So there is one catch here, right? When you say minimize the change, you are essentially trying to do this geometric distance, right? You are saying what is the, this is the geometry, this is basically VW minus VD, norm of VW minus VD, or what you would call the L2 norm, right? What is P norm? This is the P norm. So what is L0? So L0 talks about sparsity, L1 just absolute value, L2 is your normal vector Euclidean distance essentially, and so on. These are the more important norms.
Depending on which norm we are optimizing, the value also changes, right?
Yes, yes. So the object, that's the objective, the objective function itself changes. And what is L infinity? Maximum value. It is biased towards the maximum value in the vector. Everything else will be discarded, right, when you do to the infinite the power. So this P norms are interesting, important. So what I am building towards is, now we are saying that you will potentially be okay with a solution where let's say, you know, for argument's sake, let's say this is a distribution that you get, right? So every flux has changed by some 10%, 10% lower as moved in this direction, right? But the problem with that is, what does it mean biologically? Let's come back to biology. It means that biologically, every flux has to change by 10%. This is a lot of effort for your cell, right? It has to change the levels of so many enzymes, and potentially, right, it could, if it is in a particular zone, it can be a passive regulation. So if you are on, if you are in this range of the Michaelis-Menten curve, the regulation is easy. You just go up, go down, you linearly change, right? If the substrate concentration goes down, you can quickly change. But anyway, that apart, if you want to achieve this, the cell must do some significant regulatory machinery change. Say stop this, stop this, stop this, increase that, something of that sort, which is a lot of work. So somebody, another group of scientists suggested that instead of minimizing the L2 norm, why don't we minimize the number of significant changes, which is approximately this, but not exactly.
Approximately should be L1, right?
Number of changes. Just, I am just talking about the number. So how sparse is that vector? Remember, we also briefly discussed this when we were looking at network reconstruction, right? Can you find a sparse reconstruction from your microarray data, right? We say you know, some xi is sigma wi xi, the gi is sigma alpha I gi, and we will find the sparse alpha vector that will map the network, right. So this technique that we just saw is called, so it is spelled with a small or capital O, minimization of metabolic adjustment.
That is L0, not L2.
That is L2. L2 norm. So the idea is, it's this method is good at predicting metabolic steady state following the adaptation to a perturbation like a gene knockout. The premise is that an organism adapts to any stress or any perturbation by minimizing the changes from the wild type flux, and this avoids the maximum growth objective function, which is where we started. We said to delete a few genes and then say try to maximize growth seems to be a harsh ask of the cell. The cell may not be doing that. So the formulation is this. Remember, of course, SV equal to 0 always, inviolable stoichiometry constraints. We are talking about steady states. So there is some change you have inflicted, like a deletion. Do we have a new steady state or are we still in the transient state, right? That is a good question. We will come back to that in a moment. In this video, I hope you got an introduction to this interesting technique known as minimization of metabolic adjustment. It is also very useful when you want to fit experimentally measured fluxes, or when you want to see if your model can admit or fit the experimentally measured fluxes. In the next video, we will look at a related technique known as regulatory on-off minimization. So both of these techniques try to minimize the differences from an original flux vector, which may be obtained either through experiments or through FBA, and have different premises for going about what they do.